protein enterocyte. All I did was write protein enterocyte very sloppily. Okay. So the first thing we should do on any enterocyte is go ahead and draw the sodium potassium pump. Pump three sodiums out, two potassiums in, minus, 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 plus, plus, plus. That's going to be done at the expense of ATP. And now we have our sodium gradient to allow us to transport everybody else in. So we'll scoot up to the top. And the first thing we'll do is do sodium dependent transporter. And so Na plus D. And so with the sodium dependent transporter, it's going to bind to sodium, and that's going to induce a conformational change, increasing its affinity for the amino acid. I don't know why I put the plus there. Don't put the plus there. And then both of those two will be released to the inside of the cell. So by using sodium, we can transport the amino acid against its concentration gradient. And generally, this is going to favor large essential amino acids for transport. The other amino acid transporter is sodium independent. Remember, capital letter means sodium dependent. Small letter means sodium independent. And so this type of transport can only go with the amino acid's concentration gradient. And we're just going to transport an amino acid into the cell. The next transporter is PEPT1. And PEPT1 is going to be used to transport the di and tripeptides into the cell. And so we're going to transport two things, a proton and either a dipeptide or a tripeptide, one at a time, can't be both. And this di and tripeptide, through the activity of peptidase, produces an amino acid. And so we have amino acids coming from there, we have amino acids coming from the sodium independent, and we have an amino acids coming from the sodium dependent. We can use amino acids for protein synthesis. Enzymes, transporters, the like. We can also use it for energy to support the functions of the enterocyte, and then some fraction of them can leave the cell, and we're just going to create a generic transporter down here, and that generic transporter we will name amino acid transporter. And so amino acid transporter goes both ways. It can transport amino acids into and out of the enterocyte. the last thing we have to do is over here. We have to handle this proton. And so we have a sodium proton co-transporter and Na plus H plus is going to transport sodium into the cell and a proton out of the cell. Okay, remember, sodium dependent is going to diminish the electrical chemical gradient created by the sodium potassium pump down here. We're going to be able to transport amino acids against their concentration gradient. It favors large essential amino acids. There are multiple sodium dependent transporters. It's not just one, there's multiple. Sodium independent transports amino acid with this concentration gradient. Again, there's a large number of these transporters. There's only one PEPT1 that I'm aware of, and it's going to transport the dipeptides and tripeptides. And then we have over here the sodium proton exchanger. And again, that sodium proton exchanger is going to decrease or diminish the electrical chemical gradient created down here by our favorite little transporter, the sodium potassium pump. The other thing you might want to think about when you're looking at the enterocyte is remember that the enterocytes produce enteropeptidase, which is going to activate trypsinogen to trypsin. They're going to produce aminopeptidase, they're going to produce dipeptidyl aminopeptidase, and they're going to produce tripeptidase, all important in breaking peptide bonds to improve protein digestion. You might also want to keep in mind what proteins are enterocytes synthesizing, and we just listed four of them. So, okay.